God has delivered you from anything. You've got to serve notice to the devil. I ain't going back. I'm not going back to a dark life. I'm not going back to a guilt life. I'm not going back to a shame life. I'm not going back to a life where there is no productivity, a life where there is no value. Hallelujah. I'm looking forward and we're not going back. Glory be to God. I want to have the right thoughts about God. I don't want to think thoughts that I should not think. I don't want to have a mindset that I should not have. It's messed up my view. And when you do a personal reality check, when you start looking at yourself and when you start going back and equating yourself and what you have done and some of the decisions that we have made and some of the turns that we've taken and some of the roads that we have been on, we all can say, I'm not going back. We all can say, God, I don't want to go down that road any longer because you've done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. You woke me up this morning. You started me on my way. You've done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. You opened doors that there was no wrench to be able to open them. You've done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. You blessed me when 5 jobs turned me away. You yet opened a door for me. You've done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. When my body was racked with pain and I was in the hospital having to deal with this dilemma and struggle with this disease and deal with this difficulty, you brought me out. You've done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. Every now and again, you've got to begin to think about what the Lord has done for you. And if you take a moment to think on His goodness, you will take time to thank Him. Hallelujah. If you take a moment to think on the goodness of Jesus, if you take a moment to focus on how God snatched you out, how God brought you out, and how is it that God loved us so much that He would come to this earth Himself? He could have used Abram, but He didn't. He could have used Isaac, but He didn't. He could have used Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego, but He didn't. He could have used Daniel. He could have used Moses. He could have used Joshua, but He didn't. God came to this earth Himself in the form of flesh to die on the cross for our sins and to be raised from the dead for our justification and life. I said to the body of Christ on last week, it is because God watches over His own word. That's why He handled the problem Himself. God knew that we would not be able to handle it and still stand. He knew that you couldn't deal with it and still stand. He knew that I couldn't deal with it and still stand. God handled the problem Himself. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. When you have the blessed assurance that Jesus is who's mine. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. He don't just belong to you. He don't just belong to you, but I thank God today that He's mine. He's mine. He's mine. He's my very present help in a time of trouble. He's my provider. He's my door opener. He's my deliverer. I'm not talking about what happened, but I'm talking about what He said. I'm not talking about what took place. I'm talking about what He said. I'm not talking about the walls that shifted, but what did He say? Did God tell you He's going to bring you out? Did God tell you He's going to open the door? Did God tell you that He's going to be the way out of no way? Look at your neighbor and say, but what did He say? I just want to know what He said. You've taken 5 hours to tell me what you've been going through, but take a moment to tell me what He said. You've taken 5 years to harbor unforgiveness in your heart, but take 5 minutes to tell me what He said. You've taken some time to focus on all of the bad and all of the doom and all all of the gloom and all of the sad stories and all of the darkness. But can you take a moment to tell me what he said? Focus on what he said, not what they have done. Focus on what he said, not what they are saying. Focus on what he said, not what they are doing. Focus on what he said, not what you've been through. Focus on what he said. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory be to God. Hallelujah. I've got to focus on him. Hallelujah. My mind is fixed. My heart is fixed. My mind is made up. My mind is not wandering any longer throughout the wilderness, wondering, am I going to get a prayer through? Yes. Am I going to get a way out? Yes. Am I going to have a door open? Yes. Because I'm focusing on what he said. My prayers have changed, and we are no longer feeling convicted or condemned. Rather, our prayers have changed, and we are no longer feeling this sense of great condemnation and great guilt and great trouble and great fear, great terror. But our prayers have changed because we have this confidence. Hallelujah. And the Bible says this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, then he hears us. Open your mouth and ask. Open your mouth and say something. Open your mouth and make your request known. Stop sitting back wondering, is he going to? Stop sitting back wondering, is he going to come through? But you ought to take time to thank him for coming through. You ought to take time to bless him for coming through. You ought to take time to honor him and to bless him, to give him glory, to acknowledge his presence for coming through on your behalf. I could have died in this. Hallelujah. Oh, this goes beyond the car accident. This goes beyond the weapons. I could have died in my sleep, but I didn't. I could have been cut off in my sins, but I was not. I could have been cut short in my darkness, but I was not. We've come thus far to magnify him. We've come thus far to glorify him and to give him praise in this house on today. Help God. I've had the wrong thoughts about you. Far too many times I have thought for a moment that you did not love me. Far too many times I have thought for a moment that you did not care for me. But I am convinced. Just the fact that you would take care of this problem yourself, I am thoroughly convinced that you love me. Hallelujah. You love me. This does not give me a license to just do what I want. This does not give me a permission slip, a pass to just live however I want. But this reminds me of the Spirit of grace that will challenge me to live a holy life because of what you've already done for me. I'm honored to live holy. We are honored to live righteous. See, Satan wants you to focus on the sins. God wants you to focus on his work. What did he say?